When does a hero's journey begin? The moment you step outside the safety of your homes? Or when you realize the fight has just begun? Is it when you comprehend how small you are compared to the vastness?
Greetings, everyone. Jay the Filthy Casual here, coming to you through the internet. Ultimate Masters, what is it? Lots of speculation. So you may have seen news on a lot of box toppers that people got for canceled product. Imagine my shock. If you never were able to purchase anything because it was out of stock, or if you didn't decide to because you knew how bad the website was, well, you get shafted twice over because you don't get the access to the product and you don't get these lovely, fantastic things. So basically, what is it? Well, there's currently 34 out of 40 cards that have been not really spoiled, but shown. I'm going to go through them briefly here. But what is it? Well, they seem to be a lot of modern reprints and some that haven't seen reprints in a while. And with these, it's I'm not going to say it's going to make it more affordable if they're only released in foil, because Liliana of the Veil, for example, it's like $210 US right now. So with that being said, let's hop right into this here. So we're going to There we go. So, card number one is Emrakul, the Aeon's Torn. I think the ones that are missing for the remainder six fall in here, because I think Snapcaster's number five and Emrakul's number one. So, we got some missing here, which would leave one, and I think it's down near the end, one of the man lands, or possibly two of the man lands. So, you are probably aware of what all these cards do, if you've played Magic for as long as I have. Oh, look at that, a very, very inexpensive one. But, yeah, so we have Emrakul, Snapcaster Mage, Liliana of the Veil, Platinum Empyrean. Now, I'm going to stop right here, because this is going to give me the speculation of the next, or the next conspiracy theory for Magic. But when you zoom in on Platinum Empyrean, and I can't confirm it because there's no good photos of it at all anywhere, it looks like it says number 10. Liliana is also number 10. So I'm not sure if this could be a printing error or if this is number 8. It's coming after, Mythic Spoilers has put it after Liliana, so I guess they're speculating it's after her. But when I zoom in on Windows, it looks like it's 1 and a 0. Then you have Ulamog. I would suspect we would see the third one. Krakus, Dark Depths, Urborg, Ancient Tomb. All these have the actual proper mana symbols too, which is nice. Like Caverns of Souls, that's going to be a spicy reprint. And then you have hard-to-get ones like Demonic Tutor, Reanimate, Temporal Manipulation, not so much anymore because of Nexus of Fate. Life from Loam. Noble High Arch, Lord of Extinction, Bitter Blossom, Balefire Dragon, Tarmogoyf, Celestial Colonnade, Eternal Witness, Lava Call, Reaches. So you got looks like four of the five. White, blue. Yeah, the blue black one's missing. But it looks like you got four of the five man lands. Sorry, person lands. Then you have Sigara, Leovold. Now this one's going to be nice. And it's kind of weird that, because I pulled this out of a pack I bought at Toys R Us, and it looks like it's missing most of the candelabra and bookcase, even though it's the full art. That makes no sense. It's like they extended it and cut it off. I don't know. I mean, it looks really weird. Kitchen Finks, my favorite little oofs for tiny leaders. Engineer Explosives, Tasker, Through the Breach, and Vegivine. Vegivine's neat. But look at some of the art on this. Some of this is the alternate art. Some of this is the judge art. Like, it's pretty crazy. Like, the dark depths there, that's neat. It's not just the tentacles in the ice, you actually see the creature and whatnot. Yeah, so my speculation is that this may be preview cards that were sent out to people. I'm not sure in what quantities or qualities they went out, but I think it might be speculation on the possible lottery cards for the next master set. Well, why would they do that? Well, you would have your basic foils that would come with the Eternal Masters, and then you would throw the loot cards in as well. Now, I did see speculation that there's going to be kind of like a Return to Ravnica Mythic box set that would come out exclusively for LGSs, and the packs were labeled at being $3.99 US, and you would have a chance at a lottery card. Kind of like, I don't know, maybe similar to Standard Showdown. I think they were trying to explain it in that sense, which would be kind of neat. But I mean, they look nice. I mean, some of this alternate art, like Ancient Tomb, looks nice. You got kind of like the darkness that comes around, the light that comes through. They look fantastic. The Dark Depths, I'm really, really, I really like that one. Caracas, the jungle with the building in the center is nice. The Cavern of Souls, where all the soul hands are coming out. It's like, these are all nice cards. Reanimate, especially. You got a giant titan with a bunch of little skulls in the middle, or skeletons and bodies falling out of it. And then the tutor, that. I don't think I've seen the art for that tutor before, but it looks nice. The pirate with the demon behind it. And then, yeah, like. Balefire Dragon. Some of them are missed though, like Balefire Dragon and Tasigur. Like, I think the foil Tasigur is only like $2 American. But some of these are really nice and needed reprints. And I'm especially a fan of Manlands. Those are nice. But yeah, anyway, so speculation. I speculate that, like I said, this is gonna be probably lottery card set for the Ultimate Masters. But it kind of sucks that the regular people who didn't bother to go through all the troubles get nothing, which is why I was always an advocate for bringing back the player reward system. That way, you know, if you went to like 20 F&Ms in a year, you would still get a full art promo card like the old Lightning Bolts oh God, what was the other one? I know I got a Lightning Bolt and a Counterspell, but there was a whole bunch of them at one time. Some of them worth more than others, but what it is what it is. So yeah, feel free to leave in the comments below what you think is going to happen. I'd love to hear all the conspiracy theories around this. Thanks for watching. I'm Jay, the Filthy Casual, former Knight of the Roundtable, and member of the Phoenix Syndicate. Thank you for watching. If you liked this video and would like to see more like it, click the like button and subscribe. To be notified, don't forget the bell, because we all know YouTube won't do it. If you would like to support the cause further, you can donate at the links below. And I would like to thank the current supporters, because without you, this wouldn't be possible. And remember to support your local game store, as they are in the brick and mortar of the games community. I'm Jay the Filthy Casual, and thanks for stopping by.